entire spiritual teaching is drop your ego.
So ego itself is in consciousness. The aspect of ego is in consciousness.
The aspect of ego is in consciousness. The ego is like a broker, right? Ego is like a broker. You have done a property transaction, no? So property, that's a broker, somebody can call it a broker. There's a house there. He goes to a client and says, this house is very nice. And client, he says, house owner says, this, there is a money here. So they exchange the money and this guy gets the house. The broker gets a commission. The broker has no house and no money, but still he gets a commission. The ego has no intelligence and no matter, but still it is like acts like a broker between the two. We'll find out. I'm not giving you an answer, I'm just exploring, right? So the answer, if I give the answer, it will become another belief. So if I can tell you, but then I'll become a sort of preacher. So we have to discover. Ultimately, you may come to the conclusion that, oh, I generated my ego from my pocket. Okay, that's okay. So between the consciousness and matter, there cannot be any connection. And a connection appears, it's called ego. Okay? The entire teaching of spirituality, entire teaching of religion is not about your breathing practice, not about devotion, not your bhajan. Drop the ego or surrender the ego. Okay? That's the key of spiritual teaching. I'm taking step by step. We're doing a dissection, analysis, right? So there are two levels of reality. Is it clear? Consciousness and matter. So the two levels of the reality is connected by something, which is called ego. Now, ego has neither consciousness nor matter, but still it makes it life. And that life goes on and on and on and on forever, based on this, and that is called jiva. That's called individual jiva in our language.
Jiva
is the ego. Okay, jiva has the mind part, subtle mind. Ego generates the mind, and jiva borrows the consciousness. Consciousness is from me. Consciousness, so it's making living. The spirituality or enlightenment is discovering the falsehood of this ego. The ego is not real because it is connecting two different levels of reality, consciousness and matter. Okay? So now I introduce three terms: human, being, yes, sir. Ego is feeling of I am-ness, I am, aham. Okay, we'll get more detail about that, right? So I have next slides. But right now I'm breaking the news in stages. So you'll get a clarity. So what we call is the entire spiritual teaching is drop the ego. The bad news is ego cannot be dropped. Whatever, no matter how hard you try, no matter what you do, you cannot drop because it's an unreal entity connecting two things. One is consciousness and another is matter. The good news is, once you understand yourself, the ego doesn't exist. We'll find out whether it will be separated, right? So you are getting what I'm saying. The religious teachings are, drop the ego. Okay, that's all. Surrender to God means what? Drop the ego. Okay, but the ego cannot be dropped because it's not a real entity. The one who says I'm dropping the ego is the ego. It can never be dropped. But through the self-inquiry, you can dissect it and find out the self. It's 11 o'clock. Break for coffee.
Sir, before the going for coffee, 5 minutes, what we discussed.
Yeah, summarizing.
Yes, summarizing.
Okay, do you want me to summarize or somebody else is summarizing?
I have a question.
Yes, sir. I have each. We'll come. Each of them is. See, this whole Everything has to be clear. Step by step I'm making clear. And I'm trying to introduce not everything, I'm giving one shot because it'll confuse. Going step by step. Right? So, yes, madam. Prefer Kanandaran. Okay.
You said the spiritual teaching is to drop ego. And we cannot drop ego. It's the bad part of it.
Yeah.
Then how did Kuber die without dropping ego?
No, the ego went somewhere. The Kuber is the ego, which went somewhere. Kuber is not the being, not the human. It's the ego part which went somewhere. He's
so
neither human nor being.
You are telling us all go die.
Who are you? Human, being, or ego? Now the three terminals are there.
I'm neither of that.
Then no, that is question of dying, no? If you are neither of that, you are no question of dying, right? Okay, now, okay, is this methodology of discussion okay for all of you? Are you comfortable?
Yes.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, sir. Sir,
once in the summary is ready. Hello, Martin. I'm saying, is this approach of discussion and is it comfortable to all of you?
Yes.
Ego part, sir. It is super.
Okay. Super. Ego part is? All confusion over the ego. So, there are, madam, summarization, okay? All of our life, we believe that you are a human being. Belief is not our reality. Belief is superimposed on us by the society. Belief means a thought process. Suppose I call you, suppose somebody I call, you are a fool, you are a fool, you are a fool 10,000 times. He starts believing that he is a fool. He is not a fool. Okay? So, belief is something given to you. We have so many beliefs. The major belief about the self, God and the world is we are exploring here by this analytical process. Are you clear? So, you think that you are a biodata. Any of your introduction, you are biodata. Meet somebody, you know, I am a product of such and such a school, such and such an institution. I worked for 30 years and I had some 10 degrees and I have so many achievements, gold medals, many sportsmen. That's all you have to say about you. And all that belongs to the human part. And you don't have a single word to say about being part. Okay, now you have to decide whether you are human part or being part. Okay? And if you are really being part, why don't you have anything to say about it?
So the biodata belongs to the body.
Biodata belongs to whom?
The body. Of the human body.
Right, now keep the question and you find the answer. Right? Biodata belongs to the ego. Neither for human nor for the body. So, and the being is consciousness. The human is matter. They are totally different. Like darkness and light. They cannot exist together. Okay? Sun is there, no darkness. When there is darkness, there is no sun. But two different realities is connected by a glue. Stick. It's called ego. It's called
ego. What about the other creatures?
We'll find out. No? Write the question. Right? We'll write the question because all your questions will be answered as you proceed. But you write the question somewhere. Right? Other animals. Ego. Right?
Yeah.
We'll find out.
Steps
away. Huh? So. The ego is gluing them together and entire religious, whatever spiritual courses, spiritual classes, religious teachings you have gone through, in various ways they are saying drop the ego. The bad news is you cannot drop the ego because it is not real. The good news is the ego doesn't exist. Okay? So how does it exist? We will explore. Is that summary, sir? ಅದು ಹೋಗಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಇಲ್ಲ ಇದ್ದದ್ದು ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ See, ego, ego cannot go because shadow cannot be removed. I cannot remove my shadow. Shadow is the absence of light. Okay? Ego is the absence of awareness. So the shadow can be removed with the only light. Through the light of awareness, light of understanding, we have to remove that. No other way, whatever you do, you can remove the ego. So that understanding only progressively, step by step, we are doing analysis. Is that summary clear, sir?
Yes, sir.
Ego. Ego. So, madam, Kannada dalli kelidilla. Now, human beings, sir, human matta being. Manushyana deha matto atma. Being andre atma. ಎರಡು ಇರುವ ಒಂದು ಜೀವಿ. ಈ ಆತ್ಮ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಚೈತನ್ಯ, ದೇಹ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಜಡ. ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಮತ್ತು ಜಡ ಹೇಗಿದ್ದದೆ? ಬೆಳಕು ಮತ್ತು ಕತ್ತಲೆ ಇದ್ದ ಹಾಗೆ. ಬೆಳಕಿದ್ರೆ ಕತ್ತಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಕತ್ತಲೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ಬೆಳಕಿಲ್ಲ. ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಈಗ ಎರಡರ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಒಂದು ಸಾಧನೆ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಯಾವುದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ? ಇದು ಚೈತನ್ಯನೋ ಜಡನೋ? ನಾನು ಮನುಷ್ಯ, ನಾನು ದೇಹ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಬದುಕುತ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೋ? ಆ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಇರೋದ್ರೆ ದೇಹ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅವನು ಸತ್ತೋದ ಕೂಡ ಅವ್ನು ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಹೋಗಿ ಸುಟ್ಟಾಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ನು ದೇಹ ಅಲ್ಲ, ರೈಟ್? ಅವ್ನು ಚೈತನ್ಯ, ಅವ್ನು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ರಪ್ಪ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವ್ನು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಅಂತ ಅವ್ನು ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಹೋಯ್ತು. ಹಾಗೆ ನೀವು ದೇಹ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರ ಸತ್ಯನ ಅಲ್ಲ? ನೀವು ಆತ್ಮ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒಂದು ಶಬ್ದ ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕೈಗೆ. ಹಾಗೆ ನೀವು ಯಾರು? ಈ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಮತ್ತು ಜಡ ಎರಡನ್ನು ಸೇರಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಮಧ್ಯ ಇದೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಹಂಕಾರ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು. ನೀನು, ನಾನು ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ನಾನು ಆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ನಾನು ಈ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ನನಗೆ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲ್ ಬಂತು, ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ತು, ಮದುವೆ ಆಯಿತು, ಮಕ್ಕಳಾಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋನು ಈ ಅಹಂಕಾರ ಅನ್ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಣಿ. ಅಹಂಕಾರ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಜೀವನ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಆಯಿತಾ? ಇದು ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮ ಅಂದರೆ ಜೀವದ ಕತೆ. ಅದು ಏನು ಕತೆ ಅಂತ ವಿಚಾರ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಸರಿನಾ? ಸೊ ಇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಓಕೆ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್? ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 2 ಡೇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 1.5 ಡೇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಕಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು